Election Day has always been important in my life, and this year is an exceptionally important one. I hope everyone listening has voted already. If you haven't or know someone who hasn't, please go or help that someone to go. Margaret Bonds was born in 1913. When she was 7 years old, women won the right to vote. She grew up with that right, at least to the extent that discrimination allowed her to exercise it. Her teacher, Florence Price, another great African-American musician, did not. It was only because of the struggle of countless people that we have all had that right for the last 100 years. As you listen to Margaret Bonds' wonderful version of Wade in the Water, remember those struggles and the determination and power of those people. Honor them by using that right.
Thank you.
Over the last several months, I have struggled to figure out how to respond to the terrible trauma caused by racial division and inequality that has gripped our country. I don't have a great gift of words, but what I do have is my gift for music. That is my piece of a big puzzle that many people play a part in. I am only one piece of it. It calls me to perform, study, and record music by African descent people and bring their overlooked works to as many listeners as I can. When George Floyd was murdered, I asked my dear friend, Laurie Altman, a wonderful jazz pianist and composer now living in Switzerland, to write something to express our feelings. His tribute and memorial is called That Day, and this is the first performance. More than being about that day last May, it is about calmness and gentleness in the face of violence. You will hear that confrontation throughout, along with three tolls of a bell. This confrontation is central to our human life. We already know that peace and justice will prevail. Thank you. Now I would like to invite my great friend Holly Gash to sing two spirituals with me, arranged by two of the greatest spiritual arrangers, Harry Burleigh and Nathaniel Dett. Nathaniel Dett is a particular favorite of mine. I released an album of all of his solo piano music, over 2 hours worth of music, in 2015. The next year it was honored as a Critic's Choice by Gramophone UK and has been doing well on Amazon and all the streaming sites ever since. It was recently featured on NRK, the NPR equivalent in Norway. If you want to hear more of this giant of American music, you can listen to my All Dett program recorded for the Princeton University Summer Concert Series online, or go to my website, www.clippererickson.com. Thank you so much for listening. I'm obviously not saying anything new, but 2020 has been a year like no other. But in the midst of the tremendous chaos and anxiety, it's also important in another, much more positive way. It's the 250th anniversary of Beethoven's birth. In the music world, we have been forced to celebrate it in a whole new way, but celebrating we are, and all the more so. You see, Beethoven's music and life have a special meaning for us now, because he overcame so much adversity and turmoil himself. His deafness isolated him from the rest of society in a way that many of us are feeling now. There's no piece of his that better expresses the life force and determination that overcomes depression and suffering than the Sonata in C major, often called the Waldstein. Please enjoy this work and remember the message that it says to us across the 200 years since it was written. Thank you.
Thank you.